number one law, one faith, and one baptism.
Welcome to the Hour of Truth, the television ministry of the Greater Bible Way Temple of Jackson, Michigan, where Bishop Ira Combs Jr. is pastor.
You're going through some hard times, call long tears. Make no difference how difficult it is, he will serve them.
And now, the Hour of Truth is upon you.
Says in verse number 6, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Verse 7 says, of the increase of his government. The pronoun his means that he will be the head of what? Someone say the government. Now right now, someone say, well, is not he the head now? Because the scripture says, the heart of the king is in the hands of the Lord, and as the rivers of water, he turneth it whithersoever he will have it to go. That simply means that God is ultimately in charge. God is ultimately in control. Are you listening to me? Because he is omniscient, that means he knows all things. He knows all things from their beginning to their end. He knows all things altogether in their totality. Omnipresent, that means that he is everywhere. He fills all space and time and solid matter. He is omnipotent, that means that he has all power in heaven and in earth, as Jesus spoke of himself in the 28th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Matthew, around verse number 16. So we are letting you read this as you look at the picture in my preliminary introduction tonight before I get into the book of Revelation, so that you will get some sense of your association to what, Sister Baltimore, we are a part of. We are a part of a system of government that is called a democracy. What is a democracy? It says a government of the people, by the people, and for the people. And that is because the people will not allow God to be in control yet. But this is a prophecy in Isaiah 9 and 6 that lets us know there is a time coming and God will be in control of all government. I hope you will underline the scripture says, and the government. The government shall be upon his shoulder. There will be one government and there will be one person who will be the head of it. What's his name? And his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God. That is who Jesus Christ is. As the scripture says, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. Now, as God, he is the Everlasting Father. As the Son of God, he is the Prince of Peace. Because the Prince was always the Son of the Father. Now, this says he's going to be both. If you have an argument, you have to argue with the scriptures. It says his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, capital G, the Everlasting Father, capital E, if you please, and capital F after the description. That's the description, the adjective everlasting. The Everlasting, which is an adjective, Father, capital F, and the Prince of what? Us know that not only was he the Son of God, but he was God manifested in flesh. Not only was he man, he was also God. Not only was he human, he was also divine. If he wasn't, then we have no salvation. It's as simple as that. And so this then lets us know who he shall be. Isaiah 9 and 6, 7, of the increase of, someone say, his government. He will be at the head of the government. shall be increase of his government and peace, there shall be what? No end. Upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to what? Order it and to what? Establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth, even for what? Now there is an attempt at justice in our government today. We have a justice department. We have a justice system. If you look at your outline that I gave you, the skeleton slash skull is the federal government. That is the structure of the political body that we are a part of. And all of its branches, which there are three branches of the federal government. Look at your outline handout. Someone say executive, legislative, and judicial. And when Jesus Christ comes to set up his government, he will be the executor, he will be the legislator, and he will be the judge. So we understand now there are many injustices that go on because man cannot address all of them. One beautiful thing that you can say about our form of government, I've talked to many lawyers. I sat on the Attorney Discipline Board in Michigan for 6 years, served with some of the most brilliant men and women in the legal system in this country, particularly working for, of course, the Supreme Court justices of the Michigan Supreme Court, and sitting on that particular board with such individuals as Dr. St. Antoine, the Dean of the Law School at University of Michigan for many years, a statesman and a scholar of scholars. Also Judge Richard Sir Heinrich, one of the most celebrated personalities in the legal community on the face of the earth, serving on the Sixth Circuit Court of Appeals in Cincinnati, Ohio, which is the second most prestigious court in the land, second only to the U.S. Supreme Court. Served with these men for a number of years, and women. Lori McAllister, who was considered for a judicial appointment to the federal court by President George W. Bush. As a matter of fact, I had the privilege of interviewing her for that promotion. I was asked by the Bush administration to conduct the interview in the offices of Dykema Gossett in downtown Lansing. Now, these are things that God did because I am no lawyer, never been to law school in my life. Can't spell law school. But this is called favor. I can tell you that we have one of the finest judicial systems, if not the finest judicial system on the face of the earth in comparison to other countries. But this judicial system in this country will not compare to the justice that will be met out when Jesus Christ sets up his government. And I'm simply giving you an outline so that you can see that much like the systems of the human body, model that we're using to explain the system of governance that we are in today, that these particular things that we're referring to, using the skeletal and the skull of the skeletal system of our human body in a figurative way to explain the structure of our democracy in this country, having subordinate governance or governments throughout the country that in fact are set up exactly like our federal government system. Because just as there is an executive, legislative, and judicial branch on the federal level, in every state there is an executive, legislative, and judicial branch. In every state there is the governor's office, which is the executive's office, and all of the appointees, those various positions and offices that serve the government. There's the State House of Representatives and the State Senate. And then there are the judicial branches, the State Supreme Court, and all of the lower courts, which includes the appeals court that is between the Supreme Court and the lower courts that serve in the counties and the cities and townships of each state. This helps you understand that this is, someone say, structure. This is the structure of the governance that we are a part of today, including the municipalities that serve our communities on a local level, as well as the public education.